of footballing drama. Welcome to the theatre of dreams, Old Trafford. The teams then, Germany against Ukraine. I'm Peter Drury, and this is Jim Beglin. A delight to have him on board.
Thanks, Peter. Hello, everybody. I'm ready to see what unfolds in this one now.
Tries a through ball. Disposal. Standing forward, deftly done. Gets into some space. Disposal. Gets it towards the front. His way through.
Midway through the first half, and there's an impotence about this game that's causing me concern, and probably most of the stadium too. Let's just hope that by the end, it'll have been forgotten.
Look, a foul, and so he's given a free kick.
Ukraine can't seem to retain possession.
Referee's given a throw. For a throw. Now the pass. Face to face with the keeper. Goal! Ukraine! Absolutely thundered in. Keeper, no chance.
Was it just me, or did he make that look very, very easy? That was terrific skill and composure from him. He finished with such a clump.
Ukraine put themselves into the lead.
Well, that lifts some of the pressure, but they need to maintain their work rate. It's been very good up to now.
There's the end of the first half. They're slightly lacking in the goal scoring department, but they've played well overall. Just a bit unlucky perhaps to go in down at half time. I think there's no reason for them not to bounce back.
Germany didn't have a great first half. They need a change of fortune.
Germany still a single goal behind. He's not played the ball, that's a foul. And that's going to be a book. cleverly executed.
Look, should they not get back into this game, and possession stats will hold the reason why. Everything is a bit rushed, frantic. You need someone to impose a more composed approach and just settle it down.
Mats Hummels, sliding in. Schweinsteiger to the back. Mats Özil.
Just got to get the ball into the box and hope.
Chip through. Away from immediate danger. Referee's pulled play back and has booked him for the original offence.
I think you have to admire his willingness to keep plugging away, but the manager has done him a big favour, I think, by taking him off. He was looking very, very low. There just wasn't much of a gap to begin with, and to find it, I think it was a fine drive, and I don't think the keeper could have really planned for that. I think he's a bit unlucky in that instance.
It's a tiny challenge, free kick given.